Now it's like squaring a binomial. So, so you square both sides, right? So square the left, square the right. Square this first one, you get p squared. Square that last one, you're going to get q to the minus 2, right? Then it's going to become 2p over q. Right, you know the rule of multiplying squaring a binomial? Let me just write it here. You remember the rule? First term times the second term multiplied by 2. Right, so guys, listen to this. Can you see this is q to the minus 1? You remember the lesson? If it's negative, you push it down. You remember, push it. So then it becomes 2p over q. You with me? So now you got 2p over q. And this will always be, squaring a binomial, this one will always be positive. Right? Now all of this is equal to 9. Now, if you did that, watch this. This is the trick. See if you can see this somewhere. You can see it. You see? So now, this and this will give us 6. Is it minus 6 or 6? I think I wrote the question wrong. Hey, you know something wrong with me. Okay. This question, you know, it's, I found a problem here. I found a problem here, but anyway. Alright, I'm going to talk to other teachers about this one, right? Right, class, here we go. So this plus this is 6, because according to this, it says it's 6. So you're going to get 2p over q. This and this is equal to 6. Right? So you're going to take this over, and you're going to get 2p over q, because this means 2 times p over q, right, is equal to 9 minus 6. 9 minus 6? 9 minus 6 will give you 3. P over q divided by 2. Right? So 9 minus 6 is 3 divided by 2. P over q is equal to 3 over 2. What the question said you must find? Calculate the value of p over q. 3 over 2. Remember, it's a class. Here we go. Right, so look at this one nicely. All of this class, this whole bracket is to the power 0. How much will that be? 1. Some of you don't know that, guys. Anything in brackets to the power 0 will be 1. No matter. Minus 2 to the 5th is 32. That's one way of doing it, and I'll show you another way just now. You're going to push this up, it's going to become 2 squared, right? Push this down, it's going to become 1 squared. He knows that a half is 2 to the minus 1, you see? You see? Because he knows that a half is 2 to the minus 1. Now, a negative times a negative is a positive. 1 times 2 is 2. 2 squared is 4. You see, same answer. Negative 27. Okay, so our markers for negative 27. Our markers for that one. Our markers for the 1. And our markers for the 4. Prime numbers, right, class? Prime numbers. So let's look at the first prime number. So 6, that will be 2 and 3. 2 times 3, right? And that will be to the x minus 2. This one will be 2x plus 2. It's already in the prime numbers, okay? This one will be 2 to the 2x, you agree? So 2 squared is 4. So 2 to the 2x. This one will be 3x minus 4. It's already in a prime. Right, so the first mark is for prime bases, for all being prime numbers. And the other mark was for this multiplication step here, okay? The multiplication thing. Splitting that 6 into 2 and 3. You remember learning this in a lower grade? Same thing, right, Ross? Same thing. All they did here, now they got a number. Okay, so what do we do here? We apply it here. 2 x minus 2 x minus 2. You see it? Same thing. Yeah, it's practically the rest is all the same. Let me see if there's a mark for that. Right, there's no mark for that splitting. Okay, so that splitting, there's no mark. And now the simplification. So class, for the simplification, it's like this. You write down the two. And you write all the top ones, adding them, okay? X, so I'm busy with the top. X minus 2. X plus 2. So we're adding them, right, class? You agree I added all those? So only looking at the twos, okay? Don't look at the threes, the twos. This one's in the denominator. What do we do with exponents, denominator? Subtract 2x. Here we have 3 as our base. And what's our exponent? X minus 2. Now for the denominator, what do? We subtract. Watch this. Minus x plus 4. Because I'm subtracting, the signs change. Remember the rule? A negative in front of the brackets changes the sign. So the 0, 3 squared. 2 to the 0 is 1. And 3 squared is 9. Does it make sense, guys? The final mark is for the answer of 9. 1, all you had to do was convert the 1. And we did examples like this in class. Now the bases are exactly the same. Therefore, x is equal to 0. Right, so you find this question too. Many also got this one wrong. Highly. Remember we said when there's a negative, what's the rule? Break it up. You remember this lesson? Break it up. Do you remember those words I said to you? Break it up. Check it out. It's in your book. You'll be surprised. It's there. Break it up. Can you see now that it's broken? So 2x plus 1 means 2x, 2 to the 1. Okay? So when you break it up, what do you notice, class? Do you see a common factor? Take out 2x, what will be left? 2 minus 1. Let's see if that's correct. 2 to the x times 2. 2 to the x times 2. 2 to the x times minus 1, minus 2 to the x. You see if I distribute it, equals that. Now what we're going to get? We're going to get 2 to the x times 3, times 1, equals 2. I thought there was a plus. Equals 16. So 2 to the x is equal to 2 to the, 2 to the 2, 3 to the 4. X is then equal to, x is equal to 4. Equate the exponent. Where's the factors? Yeah. One mark for the factors. 3 marks in total, class. 3 marks. Right, so 5 to the x minus 2. We're given that 5 to the x is equal to 25. Then we'll substitute the 25 for 5 to the x. 5 to the minus 2 will go to the denominator. So we have 25 over 25, which is 1. The mark allocation here is 4. Okay, and that will be 3 marks. Okay, so this is 2. They tell you is equal to 4x. Calculate the value of x. Okay, so that means this triangle here is an isosceles because it has that equal to that. So all you have to do is find one other angle in here, and that's sorted. You agree? The quickest way I found was that P is equal to 120, then R1 is 120. The opposite angles of a palm. Using angles on a straight line, I could then find R2, which is 60. If R2 is 60, then T is 60, because this is an isosceles. Equal angles, opposite equal sides. 180, subtract 60. Subtract 60 will give me how much? 60. So that means this angle S2 is 60. If S2 is 60 divided by 4, I'll get an answer of 15. Because they tell me that this angle was 4x. So 4x is equal to 60 divided by 4x is 15. Another way to do it, class, was like this. Listen nicely. If this is 120, how much is this angle? 60. So if this is 120, this angle is 60. If this is 60, how much is this angle? Also 60. Alternate angles. You see it, class. And then from there, the same conclusion. Right, class, here's the answers. You can mark yours. Right, so class, either you have this option as your first option, and then you carry it on as per that, or you got this option. See where I put the star? You got this option, and then it carries on as per normal like that. Okay. Right, class, looking at this one, they tell you in quad ABCD, so no way is it a palm. They say AD is parallel to BC and B is equal to D. So class, they even gave you another angle that's equal, so you could easily work it. Alright, so one of the ways of doing this was to say that this angle equals to this angle, alternate angles. So A2 is equal to angle C1, alternate angles. Right? Then we're supposed to say angle B is equal to angle D, given, and this line is common. AC is common. Therefore, this triangle is congruent to this triangle, angle, angle, side. Okay? Angle, angle, side. Therefore, AD is equal to BC, right? Corresponding sides of the congruent triangles, but AD is parallel to BC. Therefore, it's a palm. One pair of opposite sides, both equal, proved by congruency, and parallel, which was given. You see the idea there, class. I noticed there's something wrong on this memo here. Okay, but anyway, here's the memo answer. So this one is actually B. B is equal to D. That's what it was supposed to be here. Yes, the line in the middle. AC is common. Or some people say AC equals AC, common side. Or you can say AC is common. One of those two. Right, class? Are we good? That's the memo. Just check the mark allocation there.